congested, and expensive location possible. This plan was created by county employees for county employees, with little regard for the residents that must use the court system or the taxpayers that must pay for it. The congested location and the lack of parking would make it inconvenient and expensive to reach. This round is only a fraction of what taxpayers are going to be asked to pay for soon. This is prime real estate. It'll be forever taken off the tax rolls, including many other city blocks aside from this one. And those will be removed from the tax rolls essentially forever. And there are better alternatives, none of which have been seriously explored in the last more than 15 years that the county has been planning this location. Travis County Taxpayers Union says to vote no on the civil courthouse bond proposal. Tell the county and city to work together on real alternatives. When the time comes, be happy to support a reasonable alternative that works for families and taxpayers. This is not that time. With that, I want to give the floor to City Council Member Don Zimmerman.
In this case, I'm opposed to the courthouse bond, or what I prefer to call it, courthouse loan. This will be a little long-winded, but it's critical for you to know the history. I opposed the affordable housing bond in 2013. I'm opposed to the proposed one-third of $1 billion undercover waste in its proposed location to be voted on November 3rd. I've spoken to the Austin City Council twice publicly and the Travis County Commissioner's Court three times after that decision. Remember, bonds equal taxes. Bonds equal taxes. Bonds equal more taxes. I wish we had a way of convincing renters that bonds equal rent increases, because they do. Because putting ourselves in the more debt is so important, we must really scrutinize any such loan. There are two ways to analyze a bond, a loan. One way is to look at the process and see if there are any flaws in the process. We're called here an argument to be made because if the process is flawed, you must vote no. You cannot borrow the money. The second way to attack a bond is to look at the merits, which is a vast array of reasons why a bond should or should not fail, like do we need more parkland or do we need to spend $100 million on road improvements? Critically, if the process is flawed, I believe wholeheartedly, we do not have to discuss the merits of the bond. If you can't overcome the hurdle of a flawed process, you do not even need to discuss the bond issue on the merits. It must fail by all of us voting no. For this courthouse loan, I attended an informational session where there was a slick presentation, and the cost of repayment number that was presented to us was $1,575 for $100,000 in value, or $47 for $300,000 loan to pay back the proposed $287 million loan. I asked how we got to that number. I received an answer. Once a certified roll came in, after my attendance at that informational meeting, the county played a little loose and moved the year evaluation to 2017, and lowered the impact to $1,350 per $100,000 in value, assuming an increase in taxable value for all property in Travis County. Well, it turned out that the way they got to the $1,350 number failed to include a critical piece of the courthouse loan proposal. The cost to me and you to repay the non-voter-approved certificates of obligation, another type of loan that was used to purchase the land. To this day, we have not received an answer. The process is flawed and has failed, and solely for that reason, we must vote no. Now, here's a part of my citizen communication to the county yesterday morning, public record. It took a specially called informational meeting and a city council member, Don Zimmerman, to call you out on the fact that the land that the proposed courthouse will be built upon is not paid for, but is still under a certificate of obligation, another type of loan that does not require voter approval. This came a mere 14 days before early voting commences. This came after 9 of your 12 informational meetings were already held. This is a fatal and irreparable error on your part. I was saying this to the county commissioners. In fact, the super PAC that supports this bond is using the same false numbers. Maybe you could disseminate the correct numbers to the super PAC and the statesman when you receive them. As of today, we still do not know the impact for $100,000 of value. So how do we make a decision to borrow? We cannot. So you must pull the bond, or we must vote no on this bond tax November 3rd. That was to the county. And that's the end of that speech. So even though I state we must vote no because of the process of borrowing this money, there are those borrowers who trust our public officials to do what is right and need reasons to vote against the loan that do not have to do with the process. And these reasons would be what I would call arguing on the merits. As I stated in my citizen communications, we have a unique opportunity offered by Councilmember Zimmerman, Councilmember Troskler, Councilmember Houston, to cooperate with the county on an alternative location that will not take a $400 million taxable piece of property off the tax rolls forever. And as we were literally told by the county, if you want an alternative to the proposed location, a combination of alternatives, this bond issue must fail. Even though it took an imminent bond election for people, including several of our city council members, to propose some viable alternatives that would be way cheaper in the long run to us, the taxpayers and borrowers of residents of Travis County, this is the time to look at. One such alternative involves a donation of land by the city located on the east side and going to a potential location that is way more accessible to the lowest income citizens of the city of Austin and the highest proportion of people who do not have cars and use public transit. This is from the county's own informational session. Just think, a new capital metro hub would allow our east side residents access to all portions of the county, not just downtown. In any event, if you feel that there is a viable alternative, any viable alternative to what the county has proposed, including expanding the hours of the present courthouse or moving just a portion of the services provided to a new facility, we must vote no. If you think that there are cheaper alternatives to $1/3 of $1 billion, we must vote no. If you feel that the process of your public officials forcing you to sign on the dotted line of an almost $1/3 of $1 billion loan for a new courthouse, if you feel that the process is flawed or has failed, or that our county officials have either mistakenly or intentionally lied by omission or misdirection during this loan process, specifically, for example, hiding the repayment cost of the land in their publicly disclosed impact repayment cost numbers, we must vote no. Remember again, bonds equal taxes. Thank you.
John. Thanks. Thank you. I'm taking off my hat as a city council member. Just as our county judge, Eckhart, has been promoting the downtown courthouse bonds as a private citizen, I'm also opposing the bonds as a private citizen. I want to thank Mr. Warsham and some of our other taxpayer union friends for coming out, and thank all of you for being here. I'm just going to reiterate the fact that we have been pushing this resolution in the city council to direct the city manager to work with Travis County on a less expensive location for the bond out in East Austin, East Austin Crescent. We've needed economic development in that area for many, many decades, probably dating back to the 1960s and 70s when East Austin was promised a municipal golf course out by Decker Lake. So those promises have not been kept for many decades. And now we have an opportunity to vote down this bond and relocate the project into East Austin for the reasons Mr. Warsham has already stated. I guess at this point, if you have any questions, I'd like you to ask any of the people that have spoken, if you have any questions on anything that's been said already. Starting with Mr. Warsham, he's done most of the research.
Thank you all again for coming.
So the question is, do we actually really need a new downtown civil courthouse? I think the answer to that could be maybe. I think some of the residents say there is a need. Others would say not. But unfortunately, what's on the ballot right now is a very, very expensive, overpriced downtown courthouse proposal that does not serve the needs of the people that have to pay for it and that are obligated to go. So I think the question of having the courthouse, unfortunately, what's on the ballot, it's not the question of having a new courthouse or not. It's the only thing you're allowed to vote on is this $300 million downtown boondoggle. It is extremely expensive, it's overpriced, and it doesn't really serve the people it's supposed to serve.
You mentioned before that
Bermuda
might save, you said a number, I think, 25%.
So the question is regarding the expense, the $300 million project. I have consulted with a number of real estate investors and developers who do projects. The numbers we have, the project could be done about 25 to 50% less expensive if we sell off the $30 million property downtown, move it into East Austin, a less expensive property, and use a four-story structure, a commercial structure made out of wood instead of steel and concrete, and have surface parking instead of having to excavate downtown. You could do a surface parking in a less expensive area, and the cost of the project could be reduced 25 to 50%, and we stand by those numbers.
To be able to facilitate everything in a four-story building, considering that the one now seems overcrowded as it is, parking is already a nightmare?
Correct. So if you have plenty of acreage, you can spread out a lower profile, a low-rise building of four stories. You can spread it out over many acres, and you can have plenty of acreage for free parking. There's a better way to do the project. We argue that what happened in the planning is that they only considered the downtown location. Mr. Horsham had referred to this. This project actually started back in 1999 and 2000, and the only thing they considered was a downtown location.
This speaks to whether or not alternatives have been explored. It's only been in the last few weeks that we and others have raised these questions about alternative locations, that there has apparently been an attempt by the bond advocates to say, yes, we explored alternatives. And so we've seen some very late in the game kind of predetermined conversations about what these alternatives might cost and what they might be. The fact is, and since 1999, there's only been one location explored and determined to be the appropriate location, and it was downtown. So whatever planning has taken place in the last 16 years has not included a meaningful exploration of alternatives such as the ones that have been proposed recently.
Nor for cost purposes, the county continues to avoid the swing in total taxable value. If you were to put one of the most valuable pieces of property in Austin back on the market and go to a much less valuable piece of property, the taxable value swing is what I also include in the total cost, because that's the net effect in large.
That's another good effect, is we have a tremendous demand for downtown residences. We don't have enough supply of housing, and this piece of property that's worth about $30 million could be developed into another high-rise residential building and relieve some of our housing shortage, and it would also contribute to the property tax rolls, somewhere probably at least $6 million a year if the property were sold and developed privately for badly needed residences.
The county does have a plan to develop half of the property.
We've heard about the plan. You can probably comment on the plan, but it sounds like a lot of speculation, and there's no guarantee that that development could take place.
We learned very recently in the listening session that Mr. Doherty made, we learned a little bit about that second half of the property. It is a little bit speculative. It's been a courthouse facility dramatically under par as it is now. Adding another to offset costs at the courthouse and lower the impact of taxpayers. It is speculative. It's avoiding city development codes that other developers would have to comply with. So it's basically saying we're the government, we're going to do things more aggressively or more impactful than you as a private developer. So there's a number of ways that these so-called savings are being shown for the courthouse project that are really just more intensive grabs at the surrounding properties, more parking demand, more impact locally. So yeah, the second half of the project is, at best, it's something that the courthouse will go into later. But to say that it's going to work, that it's really paying for the courthouse.
Do you guys have a different timeline yet? If you don't know in 6, what's the timeline for getting the wood and other building on the ballot?
Let me go back to construction times.
notion of just looking at construction costs and saying that construction downtown is no more expensive than construction elsewhere is, I think that's a farce. If you look at an apples-to-apples comparison, construction that is less vertical and less underground has to be less expensive. Yes, it can take more land area, and it's cheaper land. But I think to focus on these finer points of construction and siting is to miss the bigger opportunity, which is the promises that have been made and not kept to the East Austin community in terms of, you know, these economic opportunities and economic development and mobility opportunities. We could have a public sector complex. We could have a new and better reason for better transit and mobility options for the east side that they've been desperately needing for decades and promised for decades.
But do you have a timeline, like a ballpark, if this fails, how long do we have to keep the current facilities, how long do East Austin expect before they have?
If I could answer that, so the question is, what is the timeline if the bond fails? The facility we have now was built in the 1930s, and they've been managing to expand and remodel and move some departments out of the building. So there is no crisis with the current facility because they've been making do with it since the 1930s. So I think we could take several years to go back to the drawing board, cooperate with the city. So I would say within several years, there could be another proposal coming forward, maybe. Yes?
Can I make a comment about downtown elitism? East Austin completely out of the development loop. I think it's unfair. I think it's there's another word for it that everybody knows. And to deprive East Austin of all chances of growth and the gentrification that has covered this entire area at enormous expense to the city is yet another slap in the face to people on the east side of Austin.
Well, another thing that came up in our review that we had at Travis County was a slide was put up to show how many downtown law offices. There were something like 1,200 downtown law offices that they had identified and say, see, it's good to put the new courthouse downtown because all the lawyers live downtown, all their offices are downtown. We said, but what about the people that have to pay the taxes and the people that have to come to court? Where's the slide that shows where they are demographically? Some consideration for them. There was no slot. So the lawyers have been taken care of, the lawyers and judges, but the people that have to pay for it use the courthouse, they were not considered in the downtown picture. Mr. Lee, thank you for coming. Did you have anything to add on the problem that we never have anything in East Austin and the downtown courthouse could be put in East Austin? I didn't want to put you on the spot.
It's okay. I'm going fairly new to Austin. I am on.
Mr. Will you go stand by the microphone?
You stand there.
Have me mic'd up.
He's fine. Yes.
Traditional spelling, L-E-E, and
microtraditional
spelling?
Yes, M-I-C-H-A-E-L-L-E-E.